my plan that I follow since the very first day just averaged down, and I'm sure that towards the third quarter, where I expect an even further dive in, you know, bear market rallies are normal in those downturn cycles. We might come into a recession. Welcome to Virgin Galactic Fridays, and I'm currently sitting in Germany visiting some friends and family, and that's why I don't have my spacesuit on for Virgin Galactic Fridays like traditionally, but obviously we will need to talk about what is new with Virgin Galactic. And first we will talk about the space stock, then we will talk to the bear market rally, and then we will dive into the stock chart. And before we diving in, just a quick reminder, my extend day trading where we made like crazy returns while all the market is crashing, where you can escape your 9-to-5 job at some point because this is the fastest way to financial freedom, is price increasing dramatically. Okay, end of this month, and we just have like 8 seats left, the price will be $3,000. Now it's $1,297, so we more than double the price in a couple of days. So stay tuned, join, link in the description, or DM me on Instagram if you have any questions or want to save the taxes from the website. Just DM me start, and you will be ready to go. I will reply to you personally, so to make sure that you know everything to join. So with that said, let's dive in into Virgin Galactic. So one of the most important parts here is that since about a month here, mid of June, we are on a, let's say, ride where we gained so far 35%, okay? Just this week, we gained approximately 10% only, or only in this week we gained 10%, and this is because of the bear market rally right now, okay? We will talk about this in the second category of this video. But with that said, you know, it's basically sometimes it's outperforming the market because, you know, it was so much sold off that we are coming into an oversold situation. And, you know, with such a rally over the last couple of, let's say, 7 days, we are coming a little bit of an overbought situation, which means that you can also expect that we will maybe go down, you know, 10%-ish to $6 or so, okay? However, again, my plan that I follow since the very first day just averaged down, and I'm sure that towards the third quarter, where I expect an even further dive in seasonality, market cycles, you know, experts, all of those saying and indicating the same, that we might see the lows in Q3, maybe with the quarter earnings release, that, you know, it's getting much more tougher, the environment and so on. So let's see if this will work out. But, you know, I think there's still a washout coming, and, you know, this hopefully brings me to an average price on Virgin Galactic to under $10. And then, you know, I will be ready to go for the Q1 when we go to the moon. Let's dive into the topic of the bear market rally. Let's talk about quickly about the GSX. As you know, this is the gold-backed crypto asset that I'm working together with the team for very, very long time. Apollo FinTech is the company behind it, and they are working with governments, and they are doing so many crazy projects that it's very hard to compromise that in the 3 minutes, but I try, okay? So let's talk about GSX. If this is the first time you ever heard about it, it's basically a crypto asset that is backed by gold mining assets, and basically it's a fusion of a stable coin but also a growth coin. Why stable coin? Because all the value between GSX is backed by real gold mining assets. So basically, if they increase the value of the mining and the rights on the mining in Africa, they actually increasing the intrinsic value of the crypto asset. But that's not only that, they are increasing the mining assets every now and then. Now, just recently, they signed up 2 new locations, which we discussed in our last video. Here's the map where they did that. But what is more important is that, you know, for a crypto asset to be successful, it's really important that it's mass adopted. Like, look at Ethereum, okay? Ethereum is used partially as a payment, partially as, you know, the network where the most of the NFTs transactions are based on. And that's why you see all of this success for Ethereum. And I think Ethereum is very, very undervalued. But on the other side, you know, GSX is, you know, not only having the gold mining assets, but they having a team that, you know, create this cool events where they use the GSX as a payment at the farmers market, or they now also have the partnership with Noxwire where they actually try to improve the payment system of different kind of banks. So, you know, they are trying to put their arms and legs into different kind of directions, which is great, because at such an early stage that we are in the crypto world, it's great to be in so many different areas. And, you know, Africa is such an adoptable continent, because think about it, like, Africa was so underdeveloped that when the mobile phones came out, they didn't have even the normal landlines of phones. They directly jumped into the mobile phone. So in terms of payment, they could directly now jump into real crypto transactions, which they would put them even forward than other countries in Europe or other continents. So with that said, you guys now asking where you can get your hands on GSX, and this is obviously in the link below, and let's go back to the vlog. So what is a bear market rally? Now, we know that we are in a bear market since around November of last year, and this means that the most direction or the trend direction is obviously down. Okay, this is great environment for trading, and that's why we made over 600% our trading group. But this is not what we are talking about today. Obviously, I go in much deeper topic in my members group only, but I want to show you that, you know, bear market rallies are normal in those downturn cycles. Okay, so here, for example, look into 2007 to 2009, we always had smaller rallies, sometimes 9 days, 14 days, 12 days, 69 days, 26 days, you know, where we made between, let's say, what is here, the lowest 3.7 up to 25% even, when the bear market rally is even longer, okay? I have seen even people talked about 40% increase in a bear market rally after then it dive further down. And it makes sense because, first of all, we have inflation records, we have the interest rates hiking cycle, plus we might come into a recession. So those are very big negative macros that are pressuring all of the stocks, and obviously Virgin Galactic as well, specifically Virgin Galactic and the growth stocks as such, because those have a revenue perspective way into the future, and they have to go through the storm of negative macroeconomics, and that's why people are worried and try to sell the stock. Okay, so this is what is currently going on. So I think that after some time, we can expect that we go further down and see maybe 3,000, maybe 3,300 in the S&P 500. But until then, make sure to average down, because at some point we go up again. This is for sure. So let's have a look into the chart of space real quick. As we know, it's not much that we can actually do right now, but I did a little bit of a prediction that, you know, we could see a little bit upside now until we reach the upper line of this channel, and it seems like it's kind of going that way, right? You can see I started to paint the picture here, and we start to see this bear market rally going up a little bit. But I really think that without further company news, the really top here, trading top, same with the S&P at around 4,000, 4,100, 4,200, here is a kind of top for the space stock at $11 or $10.70 something. And if we are zooming out, you can see here that I believe that first in maybe in you know, I actually don't think this is happening so fast. I think it will be more in the new year that we will break out this channel and see higher levels, because we need, and this is, you know, every single time in the history of space it was the same, right? Company news, we really bounce off, you know, this trading range, boom. Okay, this was the announcement, I think, of Michael Kogleser coming on board, boom, test flights, right? Boom, announcement of test flights, and then again, you know, disappointment that they have to fix the system, right? And then again, test flight, Richard Branson flight, and so on. So this company needs news, otherwise it's really just trading along the companies, as the same with the S&P, right? With the momentum, with the day traders, algorithms trade the stock. So I think we, you know, with no news, there is no shoes, right? There's no inspiring for the stock price to go much higher. So waiting here for company news and the operation to start, and then we see also higher prices. So I hope you see also here we are earnest, the RSI levels also slightly going into overbought scenario, at least short term. I think like we are now attempting a little bit of a bounce back, so let's see. I definitely you know, stay with this long term, so I'm not worrying. I'm just very happy that I can reduce my average stock price, and let me know in the comments what you are doing.